Hi, this is Nikki, and welcome to another episode of Design Like a Pro. In this episode, I'm going to go over the most frequent InDesign shortcuts that I use almost every time that I open up InDesign and start working on a project. Now, some of these are already pretty well-known InDesign shortcuts that you can't get away from, but there may be a few in here that you didn't know about that will make your life a lot easier and quicker when working on your project. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Now, the first one that I'm going to show you, and I just have a project here, a typical postcard to get us started with various elements to show these shortcuts in use. But the very first one I want to show you is the one that I absolutely use the most, and I didn't use it right away until I discovered it. And this one is not listed in a lot of shortcut guides that you may find online, so it's not as well known, but it's definitely a lifesaver for me. And this is the Alt Shift to duplicate something. So basically, holding down Alt is going to duplicate anything for you. So if I just hold down Alt, and this works for Mac and PC, and start dragging this, I can duplicate anything that I have ready to go. See, duplicate. All right. But the reason I add the shift in line is because it keeps it in line. And a lot of times when I'm duplicating something, that's essentially what I would like to do, is keep it in line with what I already have. So by holding down Alt and Shift, now you can see that I'm duplicating and I'm staying in line with the item that I'm duplicating. So this is a very quick way to just hold down Alt Shift, select the item, and quickly duplicate it while keeping it in line with the other design. So this is great for line art. This is great when you're working with items that need to stay in a grid system, for example, or just keep things in line the way that you want to. So that's my all-time favorite little shortcut there that, definitely is my top pick. The next one I use all the time, and it's just hitting W to go in and out of preview. So a lot of times now I design in preview to get rid of seeing things off of my artboard. And what preview does is it shows you basically the print version. So it removes the excess bleeds, and you're looking at what this would look like if you printed it. So it just is a cleaner representation. So as I'm designing, I'm constantly hitting W to see what this looks like without any boxes, anything on it, any of that stuff clogging up my view. I can instantly see this and get a nice idea of where things are going with this design. So W to turn it on and off, just keep hitting W to go to preview mode and then normal view. All right. So super handy tool there. The other one that I love is to be able to fit my page into view, which it is now, but a lot of times you'll be zoomed in here and you just want to quickly see the whole thing where you're at. You can do that by hitting Command or Control Zero. So on a Mac, Control Zero, Command Zero, PC would be Control Zero, and it brings you back out so that you can see everything in view. So this would be whatever your artboard size is. Hitting Command or Control Zero is going to fit it into your view. And that said, going back and forth in Zoom, I never grab the tool. You can see the tool is over here. You can hit Z to pull up the tool to zoom in and out. But I like the shortcut, which is just holding Command or Control and then plus or minus. So on the Mac, I would hit Command, and then the plus key is going to zoom me in and the minus key is going to zoom me out. Using that all the time when I'm designing so that I can get a better view of what I'm looking at. And again, if you're in here, just hitting Command Zero is going to bring me right back out quickly so I don't have to necessarily zoom in and out. The other next shortcut I like is great for working with text when you want to quickly add some tracking or kerning. So let's grab up here. I always like to add space between my letters when I'm using all caps. So you can definitely do that over here in your character palette by adding some space, some tracking between your letters. So you can add default sets here, or you can just add what you want to. But there's a much quicker way when you are typing out your text, and that is to highlight the text And let's say you just want to add some space to the first word. You would just highlight the text that you want this to apply to, holding down Alt. This is the same for Mac or PC, by the way. So holding down Alt. Then you just hold that down, and with your arrow keys, your right and your left arrow keys, you can increase the space. And you can see that number is in fact increasing here as well. But I absolutely love to just select the text, hold down Alt, and bring that over and really mess with that because I can see it quickly as I'm doing it. So I'm not paying as much attention to the number, but more what it looks like on the screen when I'm doing that. So again, just hold Alt, arrow key right or left to bring it in. Quickly add some tracking to your text. The next shortcut is a favorite of mine for resizing objects from the center. Now, by default, you may be used to coming over to the box, transforming it by holding down Control or Command, and then bringing it down, and it sizes it that way. But say you like where your item is positioned, but you'd rather it size from the center. That way you're not messing up exactly where your item is positioned. You just want to make it a little bit smaller. So in order to do that, we can still work from the corners. That isn't going to affect it. It's the shortcut we use. So on a Mac, we're going to want to hold down Command and then Alt-Shift. So there's three keys, Command, Alt-Shift. And then on a PC, we're just going to be holding down Control Alt Shift. So three keys here, grabbing our inner corner, and you can see that it's starting to size it differently. It's actually sizing it from the center now. So we're keeping it in the same position. It's just sizing it out like that. Now, a better example is something that's a little bit smaller on your page. So let's grab this little icon here and let's duplicate him. And I'm just going to move it so you can see it. Let's just go over here in the center in the white. All right. So it works really well with small items that you just like to increase, but you like where they're positioned. You just want them to be bigger. So again, Command, Alt, Shift, and just dragging out. And you can see it stayed in the same position. It's just now larger than it was. So that's when I really like to use that set of shortcuts. When I have something on the page, I like where it's positioned. I just need it to be a little bit larger or smaller, but I want it to stay in the exact same place. So that is handy for that. The next one, you know, you may have a need for this. This is something that I don't use all the time, but it is something that is handy nonetheless. If you're dragging something out and you want to remove the color, and this can be anything that's holding color. So let's just grab this over here. It already has a fill, but if you just hit the backslash bracket, it removes the color or stroke of that item. So in this case, it was a stroke, but by hitting that backslash key, it just removed it altogether. So that's a little handy thing. So you don't necessarily have to come over here and then hit none. You could just hit backslash after you select your item and it removes the color for you. The next one is something that I frequently use, and that's toggling the fill and the stroke. So if you want to add a stroke to something or you want to add a fill to something, just hitting X is going to toggle whichever one you want. And you can see that happening here in the left panel, that depending on what I hit, now I have the color selected, now I have the stroke selected. So X is going to allow us to quickly switch between the two. And then if you want to swap the colors, so if you have two colors, one in the fill and one in the stroke, you can just hit Shift X and it's going to swap it. See, now I don't have a color because I just swapped it for the stroke color. So now I have a stroke instead. So that's just a handy little way to switch between the two, especially if you have the wrong one selected, which let's face it, that's probably one of the most annoying things in InDesign that happens is that you don't know whether you have the fill or the stroke selected. So knowing the shortcut is going to allow you to quickly fix that. So again, X is going to toggle between the two, and then Shift X is actually going to apply either the stroke or the fill to the item that you have selected. The next item that I have is for situations, a lot of times I use this in publications where I have multiple pages going on and I need to find something and quickly replace it with something else. Now, this worked when I did a catalog and I had to change all of the previous years into the next year. So for example, if you're working on a project that has 2016 all over, you can quickly change it to 2017 by using this shortcut. So in order to do that, we are going to hit Command or Control F, and it is going to bring up basically the Find and Change dialog box. Now, that in itself is just the shortcut, but while we're here, why not show you how this works? What you can do is you can type in, now we don't have these in here, but you could essentially type in 2016, change it to 2017, and you can limit it to the document. So if you had multiple pages, you're going to have more options here to keep it just to the document, keep it to that one section that you're working on, or you can apply it all the way across the board. And when you're done, you would just hit change all. And basically, it's going to take all the instances of 2016, convert it to 2017, as long as you've selected what you want. Now, be careful with this because there's been times that I've done that and I actually wanted 2016 on some pages. So if you're working on a large project, a lot of pages, make sure that you are selecting just the ones that you want this to apply to. Again, Command or Control F is going to bring that up. Note, you don't necessarily have to change anything either. You could literally just find it and then do what you want after you found it. So if you want to just find something on a page and you're not really sure which page it is, you can just use this just to find it. You don't have to put something in the Change To dialog box. All right, so there you have it, a handful of shortcuts that make your life easier when you're working on your graphic design projects. I thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe to stay up to date with all of the latest and greatest here at Design Like a Pro. Leave a comment below with some of your favorite shortcuts if they were not covered here. I'd love to see some more. I'm always on the lookout for shortcuts that make life easier. And again, remember, these are all programmed currently into InDesign, so these are not custom in any way. They're already built in. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.